CES, Consumer Electronics Show, 2012. Top Choice Innovative Products Review by Fixitech.com. Stay tuned. Fixitech.com, your trusted Southern California technology consultants and professional on-site IT services.
Thanks for tuning in to Fixitech.com. We're here at the CES 2012 Las Vegas. We're here with my buddy Amir and Sam. We'll be taking you through to a journey of new technology. That's what's coming up in 2012 and 2013. We hope you enjoy the show and you stay with us. Thank you for tuning in. We're here with Henry for Microsoft. This is a 70-inch sharp screen, touch screen.
All right, how you doing? So this is a 70-inch sharp all-in-one PC. I jokingly call it the largest tablet PC at CES, and definitely have the biggest app ecosystem versus any other tablet because this PC is running Windows 7, Windows 7 Professional. Nothing special here, but the good thing is that means all your normal apps that run on Windows run right here. So imagine this on a conference room wall or in a classroom. You can bring in your colleagues from overseas on Skype. Because it's Windows 7, it runs Skype. Because it's Windows 7, of course, it runs our favorite presentation tool, PowerPoint. You can go ahead and present your PowerPoint deck to your team right on the wall. Touch to advance the slides. At the end of your presentation, maybe you want to holler at your team a little bit about what happened here in Q3. You can just start making notes. You can make all kinds of notes and action items just like everybody always does on a whiteboard. Instead of someone at the end of the meeting having to take a photograph of the whiteboard or jot it all down and email it out, simply hit save, save it up to your network or mail it out to your team, and all the notes and everything are there, easy for you to use, because this thing is a Windows 7 PC with network capability. If you want to use it with a keyboard and mouse, of course it's got USB like any PC, wireless keyboard and mouse printer. Last thing I want to show you is if you're a teacher, so that was kind of the boardroom scenario. If you're a teacher, this is a free app called Microsoft Math. It's usually used for tablets, so why not use it on this biggest tablet that we have here? If any of you have ever done math, it's really hard to do more advanced functions on a keyboard because the symbols aren't there. So imagine a professor being able to do this, right, for his team, for his class, right? My math is terrible, but you kind of get the idea here. It's probably not a viable. But you get the solve inequality. This inequality was solved for x, you can solve for y, you can solve for f, you can plot it. There you go. Pretty cool stuff as teaching tool or whatever. The best thing, it only costs $4,600 and you can buy it right now. A full 70-inch touch PC running Windows 7 for $4,600.
I guess the question we have there is that with Windows 8 coming out right now, with multi-touch capabilities, is this still going to be able to handle the multi-touch, or is it single touch, like zooming in and zooming out?
Yeah, so this PC, as Sharp has built it, has two touch points. That is a limitation of the hardware. Windows 7 offers at least 10, I think more. Windows 8 will offer at least as many.
Fantastic. So, yeah. Thank you so much for your time.
It's my pleasure.
Thank you.
And what's great about it is that the battery life on this, they claim, is up to 9 hours of battery life. It's the thinnest that in the market you can find with 100 gigabyte hard drive SSD, ultra sharp LED. And we find this to be the most amusing and the most stylish laptop here at the CES.
We're here with Bob from Opanga Networks. They've developed a new product that allows any iPhone or any iPad to be able to pick up local televisions from anywhere in the United States.
Yeah, the device easily attaches onto your iPhone or your iPad, and what it allows you to do is pick up any over-the-air broadcasted high-definition television and play it on your device. There's no fee for that because it's just available over the standard airwaves that everybody has access to. And then the software allows you to have a full program guide to pick what television stations that you want to watch. You can even actually record television, store it on your iPad, and play it back later.
Do you mind giving us a quick demonstration on how it works?
Yeah, absolutely. Here you can see you actually have the channel guide. You have the option of going in here and actually seeing what's going to be coming up on television later in the day. So you have basically a television guide built directly into it. Then you can watch live television and any of the networks that are broadcasting at the time. And in this particular example, we have the Barefoot Contessa who takes just a second to tune it in, and there you go. Now you have live high-definition television on your iPad or iPhone.
I guess the question that most of our viewers are going to have is that how does it deal with reception problems with low-quality reception areas?
It's just like any other antenna, which is if you don't have good reception, you move it. And so particularly because you're very portable here, it's not like you have to climb up in the tree and twist the thing, right? You can actually just move to a place where you have better reception. Very easy to change channels, just like that. Maybe you get a little advertisement as you change the channel that's of interest to the television broadcasting community, that they still have advertising revenue, and then there you go, there's the next show that you have.
There we go, another great product that we see at CES 2012. Thank you for tuning in. View of the Samsung SSD 512GB. It's running a serial ATA 6GB per second and 2.5 inch thick. Now here's the insides of it.
So you can have a look at how it's made.
We're quite impressed by this product and we look for it in the market in the next couple of weeks.
Technology. It breaks the picture up into hundreds of individual quadrants, and each quadrant controls color, contrast, and detail. So the addition that we made from last year, we've doubled the number of quadrants, and last year we were controlling just contrast.
And there's a bit of a quality difference where last year and this year.
Yes, and that's what we're seeing here, because we're doing all three aspects instead of just the contrast.
What's the thickness of this one?
It's less than 1 inch.
Less than 1 inch.
Yes.
Fantastic. Yep. And what's the power consumption like? For the average consumer.
We don't have any specifications on the power consumption just yet.
Because Samsung keeps lowering their power consumption.
We do. The LEDs are as energy efficient as you can get if you compare it to like an LCD. Each LED is its own light source, so you're able to control how bright or how dark it needs to get rather than having it on full power and using a shutter or something to cover it if you need dark. It turns the light down to get the blackness.
Fantastic. Thank you so much for your time, Michael. Really appreciate it.